How are you? Now you know that our chapter gravitation completed. So we have to do numericals. So come with your NCERT test book. Open that at page number 143 of your NCERT test book. See that some of the important numericals we have to perform. You know very well how to solve the numerical. Yes, sir. So what are the way? What is the way? First, write down all the things which are given to us in the left hand side of your copy and think that what is the formula appropriate for that. So write down all the formulas on a single page in your fair notebook. Is it clear? So now see, open your NCERT test book. Question number 3, page number 143 of NCERT of your test book. See that question, what is, read them. The question is, what is the magnitude of gravitational force between the earth and a 1 kilogram object? Suppose this is the 1 kilogram object. Here it is the earth. On its surface, mass of the earth given 6 into 10 raised to the power 24 kg. Radius of the earth given 6.4 into 10 raised to the power 6 meter. What is mass given 1 kg? Mass of the earth, radius of the earth, what is the value of universal constant of gravitation? Bolo, that is 6.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 11, that is Newton into meter square divided by kg square. Yeah, this is the formula here. The formula we can write, force is equal to GMM divided by R square. R is the radius of earth, that is capital R square. It's a very important formula. What is that? Newton's law of gravitation. Put all the values, 6.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 11, mass of the earth, that is M. 6 into 10 raised to the power 24 into 1 divided by radius, that is 6.4 into 10 raised to the power 6. Ab isko aapko solve karna hai. How we can solve it? Do karo. Solve kariye isko. And solve kar liya? Yes, sir. The force is 9.8. What is the unit of the force? The unit of the force is, sir, Newton. Okay, we have done it. Very good, do it. Now, one more question. See the question number 6. Question number 6 of same page we are going to do. The question is, what happens to the force between the two objects? The force between the two objects, suppose here is your one object, here is another object. If the mass of the one object is doubled, mass of the one object, either it or it, is get doubled, then what will be the force? Dear children, you know very well, force is directly proportional to, yes sir, we know, M1 into M2 divided by R square. When the mass of the one object is doubled, if any of the doubled, either this or this, then force will be doubled. Bahut easy hai sir ye to. Koi sa bhi ek object ka mass double kiya, to force kya ho jayega? Double ho jayega. Yes sir. If the distance between the object is doubled, one time and tripled also. The second question is, if the distance between the two objects get doubled, so when the distance between the object is doubled, A is doubled, F is proportional to 1 by R square, if it is doubled, R ki jagah 2R rakh de, so it will be proportional to 2R ka whole square, so that is 1 by 4. So what is the force here? That is, force become 1 by 4th of its previous value. 1 by 4th ho gaya sir. Kyunki aapne distance double kar di. Then you got tripled 1 by 3R ka square. So sir, kya ho gaya? 1 by 9 ho gaya. The force will become 1 by 9th. Bahut easy hai na? Yes sir. So it is 1 by 4th and it is 1 by 9th. Of its previous value. The masses of both the objects are doubled. Agar ye dono hi doubled kar de, 2 year and 2 year. What we get? F is proportional to twice of M1. Twice of M2 divided by R square. 2 into 2. 4 times. Force become 4 times, sir. It's a very, very easy problem. But if you know the formula, so when the mass of the both the objects are doubled, force become 4 times. All are clear, write down. See one more question here, question number 13. See the question. Question number 13. Page number 144. Here is 144, question number 113. Read the question carefully. What is question? A ball is thrown vertically upwards like this. Look at to me. Here is a ball going upwards. Is it clear? This is the question. So read them. A ball is thrown vertically upwards with a velocity of 49 meter per second, calculate the maximum height. Maximum height we have to find out, to which it rises, and the total time it takes to return the surface of the upar ja karke wapas niche aa jaye. Ye time nikalna apne ko. Bahut dhyan se question ko padhiye. And think that what is the formula we can use for this? What is given? Speed is given. So initial speed u is equal to 49. H I have to find out. Total time, that is the time of ascent. Total time is equal to time of ascent. Upar jane ka samay. वापिस लौट के आएगा, दैट इज कॉल्ड टाइम ऑफ डिसेंट. ये अपने को निकालना है. सपोज टाइम ऑफ एसेंट इज टी, टाइम ऑफ डिसेंट इज टी, टोटल टाइम इज 2t, दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. एट मैक्सिमम हाइट व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज थ्रोन अपवर्ड, एट मैक्सिमम हाइट द फाइनल वेलोसिटी विल बिकम 0. राइट डाउन. When it is going up, in the downward direction, acceleration is there, and the acceleration is acceleration due to gravity, that is in negative direction. Body upar ja rahi hai, acceleration niche lag raha hai. That is 9.8 meter per second square. Sab hum jante hai sir, aap to kariye. So that is this one acceleration. So according to our third equation, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. इसकी जगह लिख देंगे 2a acceleration due to gravity, that is g, and height is h. This is the formula. V square 0, u square 49 का square is equal to 2 acceleration due to gravity minus 9.8. हाइट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट, तो एच यू कैन कैलकुलेट हियर, दैट इज इक्वल टू 49 इंटू 49 माइनस माइनस कैंसिल 2 इंटू 9.8, ये आ गया. सॉल्व इट. हियर दिस, हियर दिस इज ट्वाइस 490 डिवाइडेड बाय 4. सॉल्व इट. व्हेन यू डिवाइड इट दैट इज 122.5. हाइट निकालना है, दैट इज इन मीटर, दिस इज हाइट. टाइम निकालना है, फर्स्ट इक्वेशन v इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस जी टी, फाइनल वेलोसिटी इज इक्वल टू 0, 49, यस 49 प्लस जी वी नो माइनस 9.8 इंटू टाइम, टाइम तो वी कैन फाइंड आउट टी. तो टी कम्स आउट टू बी व्हेन यू सॉल्व इट 5 सेकेंड, T comes out to be 5 सेकेंड, लेकिन आने और जाने दोनों का समय निकालना है, तो 5 प्लस 5 द टोटल टाइम वुड बी 10 सेकेंड. इज दैट क्लियर? द टोटल टाइम वुड बी, द टोटल टाइम दैट इज T इज इक्वल टू 5 प्लस 5 10 सेकेंड. आंसर आ गया. तो राइट डाउन. Is it clear? So, dear children, this is the way to solve the problem. Now, come to the next question, question number 14 of same page number. A stone is released from the top of a tower. A stone is released from a top of a tower. Suppose this is the top of a tower. Height 19.6 meter, body goes down like this. So when the stone is dropped, say initial velocity becomes 0. Height given, that is 19.6 meter. And when the body is falling down, acceleration due to gravity is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Calculate its final velocity just before touching the ground. So we have to find out v. Bahut hi aasan hai sir. Yes sir. So what's the formula we have to use? We use a formula v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. We have to find out 2, that is 9.8, h, that is 19.6. This is, solve it. We can see v is equal to under root of 19.6, this and this 19.6, under root lenge, so answer will become 19.6 meter per second. Here, this is the answer. Write down. Anna, easy. It's a very simple question. Now, see the question number 17. Again, a very important question. We are going to see question number 17, question number 18. So, question number 17 of page number 144 of your NCERT. A stone is allowed to fall from the top of a tower. Suppose here is a top of a tower. And at the same time, another stone is projected vertically upwards from the ground with a velocity of 25 meter per second. Stone number 1 falling downward, stone number 2 going upward, throwing upward. Suppose it is coming from here, it is coming from here. Suppose this is the meeting point. At a point P both are meeting. Suppose the distance from here to here is x, the remaining distance would be 100 minus x. Because total is 100, it is given. This is the diagram here. This is ground. Yeah. Draw the diagram. Then we can easily solve the problem. Now, total height h is equal to 100. Let the two stone meet after a t second at a point P, which is at a height x from the ground, and from the top, that is 100 minus x. So for the stone first, upper wale stone ke liye dekhiya, for the stone first, what is u? Initial velocity is 0. Height is equal to 100 minus x. U ho gaya 0, h ho gaya 100 minus x. Acceleration due to gravity, that is g, that is 9.8 meter per second square. Ho gaya? So you can find out here. So put this value in your equation number. Equation s is equal to ut plus 1 by 2 at square. S is equal to ut plus 1 by 2 at square. S, that is this one, 100 minus x. U is 0, hata do. 1 by 2 a 9.8. And time we have to find out, that is t square. You can write here t square. That is equal to 4.9 t square. This is 100 minus x. Say it is our equation number 1. For the second stone here, for the second stone, it is throwing upward with a velocity 25 for second stone. Height from here to here, height is x. Acceleration, it is going upward against the gravity, that is minus 9.8. This is, so again use the same formula, s is equal to ut plus 1 by 2 at square. S is equal to x, u is 25, time is t plus 1 by 2 at square. A here is minus 9.8. A is 1 by 2 minus 9.8 into t square. Yeah. Write down. So x comes out to be, that is 25 t minus 4.9 t square. Yeah. This is our equation number 2. Then, both the equations 1 and 2 we have to use here. Add both the equation. Dono equation ko add kar lijiyega. So you will get it 100 minus x. And here is x. Again I am writing, if you are having problem, 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 t square. And x is equal to 25 t minus 4.9 t square. Add them. So 100 minus x plus x is equal to 25t. ये दोनों cancel हो जाएंगे. X से x cancel हो गया. तो t comes out to be 100 divided by 25. 4 second आ गया sir. It's very easy. तो t is equal to 4 second. It is clear. Put this value in equation number 1. So we are getting in equation 1. This is 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 into t square 16. Put this value here. That is equal to, multiply here, 16 into 4.9. That is around 78.4. So x comes out to be 100 minus 78.4. You will get it, the distance. That is 21.6 meter. तो टाइम आ गया ये, डिस्टेंस आ गया ये, दैट इज देयर, कंप्लीट द क्वेश्चन. इज इट क्लियर? इजी है ना? यस सर. बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है, राइट डाउन. नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. That is question number 18. Question number 18 is there. Oh, page number 144. A ball thrown up vertically upward and returns to the thrower after 6 seconds. मैंने ऊपर फेंका, वापस नीचे आ गया. ऊपर जाकर के नीचे आने में जो लगा समय है, that is 6 seconds. Find the velocity with which it was thrown up. First thing, किस velocity से इसको ऊपर फेंका गया? Find the velocity, time of ascent and time of descent. Time of ascent is equal to time of descent, that is 6/2, 3 seconds. ये दिया हुआ है. फर्स्ट द वेलोसिटी विथ विच इट वॉज थ्रोन अप. जब नीचे से ऊपर फेंक रहे, यू आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट. फाइनल वेलोसिटी इज 0. एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी इज -9.8. तो विद द हेल्प ऑफ यूर फर्स्ट इक्वेशन, यू प्लस ए टी वी 0, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट -9.8 एंड what is time 3 seconds, put it there 3, so u comes out to be 9.8 into 3 like this. So what is this? 29.4 meter per second. Multiply kar lo isko, 9 3 27 and 0.8 se multiply karoge, so you are getting here 29.4 meter per second. आ गया, आ गया. यस. देन द मैक्सिमम हाइट इट रीचेस, फॉर दैट वी हैव टू यूज फॉर्मूला वी स्क्वायर माइनस यू स्क्वायर. सर ये कौन सा फॉर्मूला कब काम में ले? इट टोटली डिपेंड्स व्हाट आर द थिंग्स गिवन टू अस एंड देन थिंक व्हाट फॉर्मूला आर एप्रोप्रिएटिंग फॉर दिस. वी स्क्वायर माइनस यू स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 2as. फाइनल वेलोसिटी हियर इज 0. इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज 29.4 का होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 2 इंटू ए दैट इज -9.8 और इंटू एस दैट इज वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. सॉल्व इट. द हाइट हियर इज एच, मान ले एच, तो एच कम्स आउट टू बी 29.4 into 29.4 divided by 2 into 9.8. Solve it, get it the answer. Near about 44.1 meter. This is a very simple. Now, last part. What is the position after 4 seconds? Third one is, what is the position after 4 seconds? At 3 seconds, at 3 seconds, ball is at the maximum height. So in the next 1 second, in the next 1 second, that is 4 seconds minus 3 seconds, 3 seconds per maximum height per. Then in the next 1 second, so we have to use formula ut plus 1/2 at square. Put here s is equal to h. ut, u is 0, plus 1/2, a is 9.8, time is 1. Solve it. That दैट इज ओनली 4.9 मीटर. दिस इज बिलो द टॉप, 4.9 मीटर बिलो द टॉप. राइट डाउन. तो दिस इज द पोजिशन आफ्टर 4 सेकेंड. इज इट क्लियर? तो आई थिंक दिस इज ऑल अबाउट ऑल द न्यूमेरिकल्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द न्यूमेरिकल्स वी हैव डन डियर चिल्ड्रन. फ्यू ऑफ देम आर लेफ्ट, दैट इज फॉर योर प्रैक्टिस. डू इट. ऑल द एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक क्वेश्चंस, इनसाइड क्वेश्चंस, ऑल आर वेरी इजी. डू इट. बाय.